Good afternoon. Welcome once again to the Porking Batteries RPM Report. I call it a one-stop electrical shop. It's located on Map Hill, St. Michael. The man behind it, or the technical specialist, is Rodney Downs. Rodney, good afternoon.
Good afternoon to you, sir.
Tell Barbadians, what is your shop and what does it do?
Well, I'm an auto electrician. I specialize in installing car stereo, car alarms, any electrical problems you have, you could check me.
And the name of the shop?
Danny Marr Auto. I'm located just above Sky Mall. After you pass Sky Mall entrance, I'm the first house on the same side of Sky Mall.
I only saw this operation recently. Where were you before? Were you always here?
I was always here. This is since about 2002 or so.
Ronnie, what's a normal day like? What's some of the common problems that you find electrical with vehicles? Let's take cars first.
Mostly you get a lot of windows that go bad, and usually find a new Toyota Corollas now, they have a problem with their headlight switch. Usually that's go bad. You might leave home now, you have light. You might go and stop by some friend also and tell you ready to leave again.
No light. What about a commercial vehicle? Like, let's say the double cab trucks.
Well, the double cab trucks, you don't really get much, so far, much problem with those. What you might find you guys might be doing is installing turbo timers, installing gauges and things like that. You know, they're trying to boost up the truck more.
What about the other vehicles, like small minibuses, minivans?
Minibuses, many mostly like they want stereo equipment, they want special bells, special horns, and things like that installed.
What's a normal day like at your shop?
Normal day, what we call a normal day is then I guess get like 3 or 4 traffic moving in. Sometimes it'd be worse than that.
You look at all things electrical.
Yes, sir.
You also look at, you also tweak machinery in terms of stereo equipment. Equipment and internal televisions.
Yes, I do.
Bluetooth and things like
yes,
that.
Yes, I do.
What's the demand like for that?
Right now, stereo equipment is very demanding. You find a lot of young guys want to put in stereos and things. As you can see now, they have one year advanced lady. She just put in what I call a stereo with Bluetooth.
But you just said only fellas, you know. You know, said it's a lady.
I said mostly. Yeah. But a lady there, she just put install a Bluetooth set for her along with an alarm. Reverse camera and reverse sensors.
Let's talk some prices now, because people hearing us talking, then they would want to know, well, what does that cost? What do things cost?
Well, installing the stereo equipment is like just the stereo alone is like $80. Now, if you want like amplifier and things like that, it starts like some $150 and a car alarm where you can stay outside and start the car from outside. That is like $225 to install. A basic one is like $150.
What about reverse cameras and things?
Reverse
like that?
Cameras like $70. The cameras and the sensors is $70 each.
Well, that's good. And that's back and front?
No, like usually only majority of people only require for the back.
But you have sensors in your front bumpers as well?
Yeah, you can put it in your front bumpers also.
But so you do it after that aftermarket thing as well?
Yeah.
Something tickles my imagination, because then you've got certain cars, Mercedes and those kind of cars, the computers tend to reject some things. How do you get around that?
Yes, they do. Well, usually tell the truth, something when it comes like that, don't make sense trying to do it, because as I see at the BMW, Mercedes, for the time you do anything, even a simple alarm, they reject the alarm. So once the vehicle comes with a factory made alarm already, I tell you guys, well, it doesn't make sense putting that one, because you have a factory made one already and it's going to confuse the whole system.
Any way to get around those kind of things with these kind of vehicles?
No, not so easy. It'd be very difficult to do.
What do you want to tell Barbadians as we close in terms of maintenance?
Well, as far as like the windows is concerned, it's like a starting motor. Have a motor in it, you need to get it serviced. Eventually, if you don't, it will stop on you at some point in time. So, say if you have a car like 5 years down the road, you can stop, get your window service. It's like $35 a window. Get the motor service and you're running again.
That's Rodney Downs of Danny Marr Auto, just at the brow of Map Hill. This has been the Porking Batteries RPM Report for another week. Join us next week when we take another look at what's happening in and around the automotive industry. I'm Trevor Thorpe. We'll come back again and talk to Danny Marr Auto and the folk out there during the year. Until then, good afternoon.